It ain't nothing but a small frame house on an acre lot. It ain't that much different from any other house on the block. And it may not look like we've got all our share of the promise, but at least one thing's for sure, I got it honest.
Gee, I'd like to buy a house, but I haven't saved any money for a down payment, and I don't think I can afford the monthly payments. Can you help me? Sure, since the value of your house will always go up, we don't need down payments anymore. And we can give you a really low interest rate for a few years, and then we'll raise it later, okay? Sure, no problem. One other thing, my employer's a real prick and he might not verify my employment. Would that be a problem? Okay. Nope, we can get you a special liar's loan, and you can verify your own income and employment, okay? You guys are awesome. You are really willing to work with guys like me. Well, we don't actually lend you the money. A bank will do that, so we don't really care if you repay the loan. We'll get our commission no matter what. Wow, let's get started. I'd better get rid of these crappy mortgage loans. They are really starting to stink up my office. Thankfully, the really smart guys in New York will buy them and perform their financial magic. I'll call them right away. I better get rid of these crappy mortgages before they start attracting flies. But who would buy this crap, boss? I've got it. First, we'll create a new security and use these crappy mortgages as collateral. We'll call it a CDO, or maybe a CMO. We can sell that CDO to investors and promise to pay them back as the mortgages are paid off. But crap is crap, isn't it? I don't get it. Sure, individually these are pretty crappy loans. But if we pull them together, only some of them will go bad. Certainly not all of them. And since housing prices always go up, we really have very little to worry about. I still don't get it. The new CDO will work like this. It will be made up of three pieces or tranches. And we'll call them the good, the not so good, and the ugly. If some of the mortgages fail, as surely some might, we'll promise to pay investors holding the good tranche first. We'll pay the not-so-good investors second, and the ugly investors last. I'm starting to get it, and because the good investors have the least risk, we'll pay them a lower interest rate than the other guys, right? The not-so-goods will get a better interest rate, and the ugly guys will get a nice, fat interest rate. Exactly. But wait, it gets better. We will buy bond insurance for the good piece. If we do that, the rating agencies will give it a really great rating in the AAA to A range. They will likely give the not so good piece a BBB to B rating. Still pretty good. We won't even bother asking them for the ugly piece.
So you've managed to create a bunch of AAA and BBB securities out of a pile of risky, stinky mortgages. Boss, you're a genius.
Yes, I know.
Okay, now who are we going to sell the three pieces to?
Those jerks at the SEC won't let us sell this stuff to widows and orphans, so we'll sell it to our sophisticated institutional clients.
Like who?
Oh, like insurance companies, banks, small towns in Norway, school boards in Kansas, to anyone who is looking for a high-quality, safe investment.
Surely nobody would buy the ugly piece, would they?
Of course not. Nobody is that stupid. We will keep that piece and pay ourselves a handsome interest rate.
This is all great, but since we are only using the smelly mortgage as collateral on an entirely new security, we haven't really gotten rid of them. Don't we have to show them on our balance sheet?
No, of course not. The guys who write the accounting rules allow us to set up a shell company in the Cayman Islands to take ownership of the mortgages. The crap goes on their balance sheet, not ours. The fancy name for it is Special Purpose Vehicle, or SPV.
That's great, but why would they let us do that? Aren't we only just moving our own crap around?
Sure, but we have convinced them that it is vitally important to the health of the U.S. financial system that investors not know about these complex transactions and what is behind them.
Sir, as an investor and a concerned citizen, I demand that you force our financial institutions to show greater transparency and openness in their financial reporting.
Get bent. Hey man, what the heck? We're not receiving our monthly payments anymore. Yeah, I meant to call you. It's been really crazy around here. Seems that those jerks who took out the mortgages back in your CDO aren't able to pay them off. Wait a minute, we bought the AAA, a good piece of CDO. You know, the safe one. We're supposed to be getting paid first. Well, unfortunately, the loans were quite a bit crappier than we originally thought, and there's very little cash coming in. Frankly, I assure you that we are as disappointed as you are. But you told me that housing prices always go up, and that your borrowers could always refinance their mortgages. Yeah, that was a bad assumption. We screwed up. Sorry. Bad assumption, my fridge in Norwegian, but what about the AAA rating from the agencies? They screwed up too. But this security was insured. What about the insurers? Are you kidding? There's no way they have enough money set aside to cover this mess. They screwed up. Well, that's just great, you jerk. What am I supposed to tell my villagers? Tell them you screwed up. Screw you. Screw you.
But at least one thing's for sure, I got it honest.